Biblical miracles have captivated believers and skeptics alike for millennia. While faith accepts these events as divine interventions, modern science offers fascinating perspectives that don't necessarily diminish their spiritual significance. Instead, examining the natural mechanisms potentially at work can deepen our appreciation for how God might operate through natural laws He created. The parting of the Red Sea. The Exodus account of Moses parting the Red Sea, Exodus chapter 14 verse 21-22, describes how the Lord drove the sea back with a strong east wind and turned it into dry land. Recent scientific research published in PLOS ONE, 2010, by Carl Drews and Wei-Ching Han from the National Center for Atmospheric Research demonstrated how a meteorological phenomenon called wind setdown could create precisely this effect. Their computer models showed that sustained 60-plus mph winds blowing across a specific section of the eastern Mediterranean, near an ancient branch of the Nile Delta, could have pushed water back, creating a temporary land bridge. Archaeological evidence from Telephone El Daba, the likely site of Ramesses mentioned in Exodus, supports the geographical plausibility of this route, while maintaining the miraculous nature of such perfect timing and conditions. The plagues of Egypt. The 10 plagues described in Exodus appear supernatural, yet their progression follows a remarkably logical ecological sequence. Blood red water, Exodus chapter 7 verse 14-25, scientific studies of red tide, algal blooms in the Nile Delta region, published in the Journal of Water and Health, 2014, show how such phenomena can deoxygenate water and appear blood-like. Frogs, lice, and flies, Exodus chapter 8, as fish die from contaminated water, amphibian populations would surge onto land to escape, followed by insect proliferation without predators. Livestock disease and boils. Research from the Emerging Infectious Diseases Journal has identified how waterborne pathogens can trigger both animal disease and human skin infections. Archaeological evidence from Ipuwer papyrus, housed in the Dutch National Museum of Antiquities, contains striking parallels to these ecological disasters. The river is blood. Pestilence throughout the land. The land is without light. The walls of Jericho. Joshua chapter 6 describes the walls of Jericho dramatically collapsing after Israelites marched around them for 7 days. Archaeological excavations at Telephone S. Sultan, Jericho, by Kathleen Kenyon uncovered evidence of collapsed walls dating to approximately the correct time period. Perhaps more intriguing is seismological research from the International Geology Review, 2001. Showing that the Jordan Valley sits on a major fault line with evidence of significant earthquake activity during that historical period. The precision timing of such a seismic event would still qualify as miraculous, even with a natural mechanism at work. The Star of Bethlehem. Matthew's account of the star guiding the Magi has fascinated astronomers for centuries. Research from astronomer Michael Molnar, The Star of Bethlehem, The Legacy of the Magi, Rutgers University Press, proposes a rare double occultation of Jupiter in the constellation Aries in 6 BCE. Ancient astrological texts housed in the Vatican Library and British Museum confirm that such a celestial event would have been interpreted as signifying a royal birth in Judea, potentially explaining why the Magi began their journey. Recent astronomical modeling from the Adler Planetarium corroborates the timing of this conjunction, showing how natural celestial mechanics could have created the appearance of a star that stopped over Bethlehem from the perspective of Jerusalem. The resurrection, the ultimate miracle. The resurrection of Jesus represents the pinnacle of biblical miracles, one that rightfully transcends purely naturalistic explanation. However, medical research into phenomena like Lazarus syndrome, spontaneous return of circulation after failed resuscitation, documented in the Journal of Emergency Medicine, reminds us how limited our understanding of the boundaries between life and death truly is. Archaeological evidence from first-century tombs in Jerusalem, particularly at sites excavated by the Israel Antiquities Authority, confirms the historical accuracy of burial practices described in the Gospels, grounding the supernatural event in authentic historical context. The divine balance. These scientific perspectives does not diminish the miraculous nature of biblical events. Use your God-given brain, think. Rather, they showcase a God who might work through natural laws while maintaining perfect timing, location, and purpose. The Bible itself often notes the natural components of miracles, the wind at the Red Sea, the ram's horns at Jericho, while emphasizing divine orchestration. As physicist and theologian John Polkinghorne wrote, God is not a God of magic but of order, who created a world with regularities that we call the laws of nature. Perhaps the most profound miracle is not that God occasionally breaks natural laws, but that he created a universe where natural laws themselves can accomplish his purposes at precisely the right moment. When science illuminates potential mechanisms behind biblical miracles, it invites us to appreciate the deeper complexity of God's work. A creator who might utilize the very natural laws he established to accomplish supernatural purposes. What biblical miracle would you find most interesting to explore from this perspective of faith and science working together?